Questions come in the form of sound waves, so we'll start with a generic sound wave given as such. This wave function doesn't tell us much, but we can use quantum mechanics, a field of study dedicated to wave functions, to determine the origin of the question. To find who asked, we'll need a set of unique quantities that can tie this question, or the sound wave, to a unique person. To find these quantities, we'll need what are known as operators. In physics, operators are said to act on a wave function, which means they output the value we want to measure multiplied by the original wave function. First, we can start by modifying the energy operator to measure the frequency of the wave, or basically taking the time derivative and dividing by 2π. This lets us know if the question was asked by a whiny little prick like me or someone normal. Next, we'll take the kinetic energy operator and split it into two parts. The momentum operator divided by mass will give us the flow velocity u, and the momentum operator is the spatial derivative multiplied by some constants. Energy will tell us how loudly the question was asked, which lets us differentiate between a child and some antisocial idiot trying to be clever on the internet. And finally, we'll need the distance the wave has traveled. Since nobody's asking any curveballs, we can assume the wave has only traveled in a straight line, so the displacement, s, will be the same as the distance. Physicists like to use natural units, so we can let all the stupid h equal 1, and we'll multiply by c to help manipulate the expression we've obtained. You might already see where this is going, but rearranging the terms, we get the following expression, ifuc in the word ask. So the answer to the question, who asked, is I fuck in ask.